If you had asked me earlier that week what I would be doing, smoking mobsters would have been the last thing I'd guessed. Hell, I don't even smoke cigarettes. Here, let me go back a ways to help explain how I got myself in this situation to begin with. Whoa, that is too far back. But I do see how that can explain some things. Yep, I work at a breakfast restaurant. It's pretty much like a hospice with better food, catering to the everyone of people who have more Vietnam flashbacks than erections. Alright, cell phone's off. This is where it starts getting important.
Hey! David!
What's up, Matt?
I need you for something.
You're not fucking using my trunk again.
No. Poker game with the fellas, we need another guy. But if it makes you feel better, you can keep the gun that's in there. He don't need it anymore.
You know I don't fit in with those kind of people.
Hang on. Hello? Yeah, Jacob, what's going on? No, he'll be there. Yeah. Yeah, wouldn't miss it for the world. Alright. Peace.
Do I need to bring or wear anything?
Keep it casual. Wouldn't want you spending any more money, right?
See you later. Later.
David, get your ass over here. I'm fucking losing money without you.
It ain't his fault.
Casual my ass.
Fuck.
So what you guys got?
Better luck next time.
Excuse me? How about better luck right fucking now?
What the fuck?
It's time for you to leave.
Don't you think that was a little harsh?
Shut up, Matthew.
Hello? It wasn't until about a week later that I found out that Matthew was actually dead. Sure, he was a prick, but the guy was still my friend. Matthew was always telling me that I needed to get myself in the mobster life, telling me I needed to meet some people, you know, do something with my life. I kept telling him, you know, killing isn't exactly my thing. I don't like holding a gun. He would have been proud.
Come check it out for
until we close our eyes for good.